I done my share of bootlegging. Up there, if you engage in what the federal government calls illegal activity, but what we call just a man trying to make a living for his family selling a little moonshine liquor, it behooves oneself to keep his wits. Long story short, we hear a story too good to be true. It ain't.
So in this video, I am going to show you how to use this amazing Rope application on massive compute with amazing staggering 20 threads speed, very fast, very cheap. If you are following my tutorials, I have published the Windows tutorial of this application like 2 days ago. I have explained a lot of stuff there, so you should watch it. But in this tutorial, I will show you how to install and use this amazing application on massive compute. So if you don't have a GPU on your computer, you will be able to use this application with the maximum speed available. So as usual, we will download our installer zip files from here. The link of this post will be in the description of the video. Then let's move it into any folder where we want. Let's move it into R drive and extract into our R drive. You can extract it anywhere. After extraction, enter inside the folder and we have the installer scripts and all the instructions. Let's open the instructions readme file. So this is the readme file. First of all, you need to register the massive compute. If you register by using this link, I appreciate that. Also, we have a coupon code, so registering from this link may be more helpful. Once you registered and added your billing details, we are going to go deploy from this menu. Now this is super important. We are going to select RTX A6000 GPU because for this GPU we have a super special coupon code. From the category, select the creator. From image, select SECourses. Now you see currently this is 62 cents per hour, but we are going to apply our coupon like this SECourses. Verify. After you did that, you will get a price of 31 cents per hour. This is super amazing. This is much more cheaper than RAMPOT, and massive compute is working many times better than RAMPOT. After doing this, you can also set multiple GPUs, but I am going to use single GPU and deploy. Once you deploy it, just wait it to be initialized. I also have this another instance, so I am going to terminate it and just wait the initialization. Moreover, when you are deploying, do not select this RTX A6000 alt config. Alt config has lesser RAM, you see 24 GB. Also our coupon code will not work on that. So RTX A6000 is the very best GPU. With RTX A6000 you will be able to use 20 threads. I am going to show you and it will be super fast. This is the fastest deepfake face swapping application available on the open source community right now. It will be super fast to change the entire movie, video or image into a deepfaked face swapped image. So let's check out the running instance, still initializing. Meanwhile, let me show you how we are going to connect to this machine. To connect this machine, we are going to use ThinLinc client. So type ThinLinc. The link of this will be in the description of the video. So let's go to the ThinLinc from here. If you are using Mac, download Mac. If you are using Linux, download Linux. I am using Windows, so therefore I am going to download Windows. After downloaded, just click it. It will ask you permission, accept by yes, then click next, accept terms and license agreement, install into default folder and just wait install to be completed, then run the ThinLinc client. In the ThinLinc client, before we start, we are going to set up a synchronization folder. This is super important. If you don't see this advanced settings, click here and then click options. In the options menu, go to the local devices and disable other devices we don't need, just enable the drives. Click details. In the details, we are going to add a folder path from our computer which will be synchronized with the remote server. Now I am going to add the path again, so you will see I am going to add a path from my R disk drive. It is named as massive compute, mass compute. You can add any folder and just it. If you want this folder to be only one side, make it read only, but I want it to be double side, so I will download the files from the remote server as well. So it is read and write, and click OK and click OK. Now just wait for initialization to be completed. The machine is initialized. You see status running. Now we can connect. To connect it, click here to copy the login IP, then paste it. You see, we just paste the IP, not the HTTP part or the port part. Username is Ubuntu and Ubuntu, and copy the password and paste it. Then click connect. Then you will get this message, click connect. You see there is also end existing session option. If you select it, it will restart the machine. So do not select it unless you need it, like the synchronization is broken or something. On this screen, do not wait, just click start. And after few seconds, you will get to this screen. So this is the machine that we have rented from the massive compute. It is running on a cloud remote server, so it is not related to our computer. Whatever we do will be running on the remote server. So this server has 48 GB RAM memory and also 48 GB GPU memory. To see the GPU, let's type nvitop like this, and it will show us the GPU. You see we have 48 GB GPU. Okay, so how we are going to install it? Double click the home icon here. It will open the home menu. In here, scroll down and go to the thin drives. This is the folder where we will see our synchronization folder. You see mass compute. So these files are from my computer. When you get this software updater, just click cancel. And then you see these are the folders from my own computer. So my installer file is not here yet. Let's move the installer files into there. So this was our installers. I am copying it and pasting into my mass compute synchronization folder. After I copy paste it, just refresh here and it should arrive here in a moment. You see it is loading, and yes. Now do not install into the synchronization folder. Where to install, just drag and drop it into the desktop like this. So it will be moved and copied to the desktop. Yes, it is copied into the right bottom of the screen. So I moved it to here, you see. And you see all file operations have been completed. Now open the folder. And inside this folder, all you need to do is open massive compute instructions read.txt file. Just copy this installation command with Control C. Then go back to the folder. You see home desktop Rope version 4. In here, click this three dots icon and open in terminal. Now in this terminal, you see we are inside desktop Rope version 4. Just right click and paste and hit enter. You see I copy pasted this installation command and nothing else you need. It will install everything automatically, download all of the models automatically. Then we will just start the application after the installation has been completed. So the installation has been completed. It is pretty fast, under 5 minutes. The massive compute is working super fast. You see virtual environment made and installed properly. So how we are going to start it? Let's enter inside the folder where we have installed. You see it is installed here. Let's open back the instructions and just copy this command, Control C, return back to the folder, and on this folder open a new terminal. You see desktop Rope version 4, paste and hit enter, and that's it. This will start the application and it will be ready to use. Yes, it is started. Now I suggest you to watch the Windows tutorial. Why? Because I have explained everything in this tutorial about how to use, and how to use is totally same. So I am first going to select videos folder. You see it started from here, and I have example videos inside. Example face video, this is automatically downloaded for you with my script, but you can use your videos, of course. So how you can use your own videos? Put them into your synchronization folder. Then when you click this select videos folder from here, and when you go to the top like this and go to the thin drives here and go to inside your synchronization folder, your video files will appear here. So you can select here to list all the available videos inside that folder. When you select the folder, it will scan the folder and refresh the video's content. Currently it is, I think, still scanning. Let's see. Okay, it is trying to find whether there are any videos inside that folder. Yes, it found one file there. So let's return back to our examples, which are inside. Let's go to the directory here. Okay, let's go to the home directory, Ubuntu. This is where we are. It may be a little bit confusing in the first time when you are using inside desktop, inside Rope version 4, inside example face video. And okay, and you see it's kind of the folders. Then let's select the faces folder. So let's just click the faces folder selection, and you see same folder selected. This is where my files are. So I'm just going to okay, and it will list me all the example faces as well. So let's select the test video mp4 file, and let's click the find faces. Let's select this face. Then which faces I will use. In the Windows tutorial, I have shown how to use just a single face. So let's just select the first face. Okay, it is selected. Then we need to click swap faces and just wait for this face to be updated first. When you are waiting for update, do not click anything else. Just wait operation to complete it. Unfortunately, the interface is not displaying the status. Yes, you see it is changed. Then let's select the swapper resolution. Okay, it is applied. You see it is significantly improved. Then let's also use the restorer. I use GPEN 512. This is best original. Let's enable it from here. The interface is not working as good as on Windows, but it is working. Yes, you see it is applied. However, it may be too strong. So let's make it 30%. And yes, it is better. I also use strength. And I make this 20. I explained all of this in the Windows tutorial. Let's make the strength like 120. Once you change the numbers, hit enter. Let's also enable occluder face parser to fix the mouth. So I will make the mouth 1 like this. And yes, it is all ready for this character. You see, as I move, it will get updated. You can also select multiple faces. It will average them. So let's say I select this face like this, and then I am going to select this face like this. So it is going to use both of these faces averages. The mouth is still not looking very good. So let's make the mouth 10, and it should fix it after we hit enter. Yes, you see you need to hit enter so the slider will change. Until that time it won't work. Okay, 1 is working perfect. Then let's also fix the face for this character as well. Let's select it from here. Okay, after we selected it, you see it will become red. Just wait because ThinLinc client is a little bit delayed. Then which one, replace it with this person. Okay, let's just wait, and then let's also average with this face. So I am going to use these two faces. To select more than one face, keep pressing the control key, so it will allow you to select multiple faces. Okay, let's see. Yes, both faces are now selected. There is a little bit delay when you are using with the ThinLinc client, but it is working fine. And yes, everything is set. So how we are going to save it? Let's go to the very beginning or click here, and we need to select output folder. I am going to output it into my synchronization folder so that I can immediately download it from my own computer. Let's go to the thin drives, mass compute, and okay. And that's it. We did set everything. Now on massive compute, we have huge amount of VRAM. You see, I used the nvitop command, and it is displaying VRAM usage. It is only using 4 GB right now. Therefore, I am going to increase this thread count to 20. So it will process 20 frames at a time. And let me show you the real-time speed of this and the VRAM usage. It is just mind-blowingly fast. There is no such application fast as this one. So click record from here and click play. And then let's return back to here and let's watch it. It is going to use over 30 GB VRAM. And let's see the speed once it starts. Yes, just look at this speed. This is real-time speed, real-time processing speed. You see the speed, it is just mind-blowing. It is already over 30 frames. It is processing. This is real-time speed. It is using over 30 GB VRAM. So with the massive compute, only 31 cents per hour, we are able to use 20 threads. This is the demo video that I have shown in the beginning. So you see, this is how we use mass compute. It is just mind-blowingly fast, and it is also super cheap. If you use RAM pod, it will be much more pricey. It is 69 cents on RAM pod for the same GPU. Moreover, on RAM pod, there is no such desktop virtual machine. We did set up this virtual machine so that this application will work perfectly. We did install the necessary libraries, necessary drivers. Moreover, if you are a Linux user that you are using Linux Ubuntu on your own PC, then you can use this script exactly there. Just make sure that you have installed CUDA 11.8. What I mean by that, let's open a new window. This is just for local users, not the users that are going to use method compute. nvcc --version. So you should get CUDA 11.8. And when you type Python 3, you should get 3.10.12. If you have installed Python, not Python 3, you can modify my installer script and then just use the installer as it is. It should work. Okay, we are almost done. Okay, video is rendered and save it, but I noticed two errors. You see, even though we have written 30 here, the slider is not changed because we couldn't hit the enter accurately. When you hit enter, you need to see the slider changed. You see the face changed, so it wasn't accurate rendering. And also this was also not changed. So I hit enter and you see slider changed, and I hit enter, you see slider changed. You need to be careful with the enter keyboard and make sure that it is working. I'm going to take another render, then I will show you the result and we will end the tutorial. Okay, I click play. So you first click the record and you click the play to make it play it. If you want to just replace an image, you use this image tab. I have shown how to use it in the Windows tutorial. You really should watch the Windows tutorial because a lot of information is explained in this tutorial. Okay, new video rendering is also completed. Let's go to the our synchronization folder. This is on my computer, you see. Then let's double click and see the video. Yes, it is working amazing. It is synchronized with my computer, so I can use it. Moreover, my installer script is also installing a video file player, so you can also use the method compute to watch the videos. Let's go to the synchronization folder inside home, inside thin drives, mass compute, and in here you can just double click the video files, by the way, not the temporary files but the full files, and you will be able to play the video inside the method compute as well. I hope you have enjoyed. Please also consider supporting the original author of the Rope. In the right bottom of the application, you will see Enjoy Rope, Please Support PayPal. When you click that link, you will get to this page. Please also consider supporting the original author of the Rope, Hill Over, so that he can make better applications. If you have any questions, just message me from Patreon or from this video. So this will run on the remote computer. You don't even need to have a GPU to run this, just the computer where you can install the ThinLinc client. It can be Mac, Linux, Windows, whatever, and then use it to connect to the remote method compute cloud server. Before you terminate your method compute instance, make sure that you have downloaded every file, because once you terminate, all the data will be permanently deleted. You won't be able to recover them. You see, selecting terminate will delete all data on this VM, virtual machine, and recycle the machine. So make sure that you have saved everything, then just terminate and that's it. Hopefully see you in another more amazing tutorials. More amazing tutorials are coming. We have Patreon post index on the Patreon, on the GitHub, and we have so many amazing applications. I have also tutorials for them on the channel, so you can ask me the question and I can forward you to the accurate script tutorial, the post. Hopefully see you in another amazing tutorial. And please also, one more thing, please also start our repository. You see, we are at 1800 stars. Also fork it and watch it. I appreciate it. You can also sponsor me. Also, don't forget to join our Discord channel. You see, this is our Discord channel. When you click it, you will get to this page, and we have over 7000 members, over 1000 online members. So join and talk with us. This is free. You don't need to be my Patreon supporter. Just join the Discord and talk with the community and me.